When iOS 18 comes out this fall, you'll be able to add shortcuts right on the lock screen. That means you'll be able to replace the flashlight and camera icon shortcuts right here and swap them out for a shortcut. And not only that, but you'll also be able to place shortcuts in the control center here. So in this video, I'm going to give you 18 shortcuts ideas for iOS 18 for shortcuts that you can place on your lock screen. Things like calculating travel time to work and letting people know you're going to be late. New actions coming to iOS 18 like toggling smart home devices, running a health tracker from the lock screen, start timers to track your work, skip the intro of the podcast and start playing, translation right from the lock screen, and a ton more. Links to download these shortcuts will be in the video description. Peep the shirt and let's get started. Let's go to the Shortcuts app and first create a running late to work shortcut. This could also work for running late to class or other events, but this is a simple shortcut. I've added the Get Travel Time action, and you can get driving time from your current location to whatever location you'd like. You can choose your school or work address or search for a location here. Then I added a text block that says, sorry, running late, be there in, and you can pull the travel time from the first action and it will appear in minutes. When I run this shortcut, you'll see the text that generates, sorry, running late, be there in 24 minutes. Then you can add a text action or even email action. This way you can notify your team or your coworkers that you're running late. Let's do a send message action, and this will send that text to whoever you choose, and you can have multiple recipients in that for a group text. Expand that send message option, and where it says show and run, toggle that off. This way you can run the shortcut from the lock screen, it'll automatically send that message, and there's no further action on your part. I'll run this shortcut, and let's see if it sent myself a text message. Yeah, and sure enough, there's the message, sorry, running late, be there in 24 minutes. Now for the second shortcut, we're gonna put a little sriracha on this and we can actually get our next calendar event and then get the travel time from current location to that calendar event. So right here, I have our get calendar events action, get one event and then choose the calendar, maybe it's your work calendar or school, and that will get the next event. Then you can get details of that event and I have location here. Make sure you put the address in your events in that location field. This way the shortcut can pull it. Then I get driving directions from current location to the next event location, and we have the same kind of text, running late, and we can play this. It's gonna get the next calendar event, the address for that event, and you see we now have 33 minutes to that destination. This might also work if you tend to run late for maybe dates with a significant other or something else. You can automatically get the travel time to that next event, put that send message or even send an email at the bottom, and then you can quickly notify whoever you'd like that you're running late. All right, for this next toggle, I'm gonna show you one of the new actions in iOS 18. If I go to the shortcuts here, you'll see it looks a little different than previous iOS versions. I'll create a new shortcut and I'll search for home actions. Previously, when you wanted to toggle a home device, you had to use an if statement and getting the status of that device, but now you can just do toggle accessory state. This can now be a one-step shortcut. Toggle that, expand the menu, choose the accessory you'd like to toggle, and now this shortcut will toggle that lamp, light, or whatever other device on or off. Put the shortcut on your lock screen, and now you have a quick toggle for that. But what if you want something a little more complex? Well, you can create a menu that gives you options for multiple accessories, or you can do something even fancier, and right here I actually have a format current date, and it's going to format the date in the 24-hour style. You can see here formatting the date custom and just one capital H for that format string, and it's gonna give me the hour in 0 to 23. Then I get the number from that, and in this if statement, I have if number is greater than 19, which means if it's 8 p.m. or later, then it's gonna set my good night scene when I run this shortcut. Otherwise, if it's earlier in the day, it's gonna set my office work scene, which turns on my office, raises my blinds, and things like that. Now I have one shortcut that, depending on the time of day, will actually control different scenes and accessories. This gets even more powerful with a change to if statements in iOS 18. Again, this fall when you update to iOS 18, the if statement is upgraded and actually gives you a lot more flexibility. So let's say we want to create a conditional if statement for when we're home and a time of day. Well, for that, I'm going to do get current location as the first action, and then let's find our if statement. Remember, we can choose many different options for the location part. Maybe it's city, or even street address if we want to be really precise. We could say if city is not, and then maybe put your hometown, this way if you're away from home. And this is the big change that's gonna make these if statements way easier. I'm gonna hit the plus icon here, and I can add multiple conditions to this if statement where previously I would have had to create multiple if statements. So now I can say if I'm away from my current city, and let me choose something like current date, and maybe this is gonna be by time, and if the current time contains PM, and I can change the if statement from any to all. Now this if statement is not only gonna get my location, but also look at the time to say if I'm away from home and it's in the afternoon or evening because the time says PM, Then I can add my actions here and otherwise actions below that. This change to if statements, being able to add multiple conditions and change it from any to all, is going to open up a world of possibilities. Once iOS 18 is out and available to more people, we're going to build a ton of new shortcuts using this new if statement. So make sure to subscribe to the channel right here, and we're going to be covering those very soon. I've created a shortcut here where you can run it right before a class or before you're going into work. And what this is going to do is get the next event in your calendar. And if there is something in that calendar that starts in the next 15 minutes, it's going to run some actions. Again, this is great to run, maybe connected to your class calendar or work schedule. This way, when you run it, it's going to check whether or not there's actually something coming up. Then, under that if statement, we're going to turn on Do Not Disturb mode so we don't get any notifications, but I'm going to add some things to this because I also want to silence my device. Now, this is only available on the iPhone 15 Pro, but I can add a Set Silent Mode action. I'll put that under the Focus mode. We're going to turn Silent Mode on. And to confirm that these actions actually ran, I'm actually going to add a Vibrate Device. I like adding this to a lot of shortcuts that have multiple steps just to make sure everything worked properly. So now when I run this shortcut from the lock screen, it's going to check, do I have a class coming up or am I heading into work? And if so, turn on Do Not Disturb and then disable that Do Not Disturb automatically when that event is over. This way, once you're out of class, you don't have to worry about missing those notifications. It's going to turn silent mode on the phone and vibrate the device. But you know what? Let me add one more just in case I open a social media app during class. I want to make sure the volume for my device is set at zero. So not only am I going to turn silent mode on, but I'm going to turn my media volume all the way down to zero. So now, just in case I open something like TikTok in the middle of class, no sound is going to come from my device. Remember, links to this and all the other shortcuts are down in the video description. Next, I actually created a shortcut for my wife who's trying to track different things in her health. And this is a long shortcut that asks a bunch of questions like, did you do your nasal spray? What are some symptoms you're experiencing today? What are supplements you took? And it basically runs through all these different questions. It puts it all in this report format and then actually appends that text to a note in Apple Notes. This way you just have one note with a running log of everything that's been going on day to day. And you can run this multiple times a day or just once a day to kind of track all that stuff. Just to show you what it looks like, when I run this shortcut, you can see it asks the questions, nasal spray, yes. What supplements did you take today? What symptoms have been going on? And then it actually asks to rate certain things, like how's your sleep quality been? Maybe that was a 4 out of 5. Did you work out today? Things like that. Mental clarity, energy level, symptom severity, and a place to add any further notes. And when I hit done, it's actually going to append all that data to a note. And you see, this is what the health log looks like. And now all those questions with the ratings and different things from that day with today's date and time is all logged to keep track. Again, you'll probably want to customize this pretty heavily to meet your needs, but having that kind of shortcut on your lock screen means you're probably more likely to keep track of those data points for your health more consistently. All right, the next one, if you track your time maybe for productivity or billable hours, this is actually using actions from the app Toggle Track, which means you can start and stop timers. There's also another app called Timery, which gives you more flexibility, but this has worked for me. I start with a menu, meaning I can start different timers right from the shortcut menu, depending on what work I'm doing. And there's also an action to stop the timer. This way I can do it all from a single shortcut. Then when I run this shortcut, I can choose what am I working on. And that started the timer. Now it's running in the background. Then when I'm done working, I can tap that same shortcut again, hit stop timer. It'll show you how much time was logged, the project and task. And that's a quick way to track your time. Again, a lot of these can be mapped to the action button as well if you have a 15 Pro, but for older iPhones, and ones without an action button, putting these on the lock screen makes it really convenient. Next, one of the things you probably do often is enable AirDrop, maybe to everyone or to specific contacts. And so having this as a quick toggle right on the lock screen just saves you a few taps from going to Control Center. When I run this shortcut, I can choose whether I want to turn AirDrop on, off, or just for contacts. And if I want to turn it off, just right there, and I can go to Control Center and see AirDrop is now currently off. Run it again, and I'll do contacts only. And now AirDrop is contacts only. Again, just a little faster way if you find yourself airdropping things often. And to combine AirDrop with maybe choosing a file, this shortcut, it's simple, two-step, but basically allows me to select a file from the Files app on my iPhone and then automatically AirDrop that file. Saves me a few taps. I don't have to dive into the Files app. I can just run this shortcut here. Maybe I want to share the artwork for Primary Technology, my tech podcast with Jason Aten. You should definitely follow and subscribe. Links are down in the description. But I'll tap the file. It'll automatically start the AirDrop session. And it brings up the share sheet. I can also send it many different ways, but one tap to AirDrop, find people nearby, quickly sharing files right from the shortcut. Next, if you listen to a lot of podcasts like I do, having a Play podcast right on the lock screen is going to save you a few more taps. This way you don't have to unlock your phone, swipe to go home, or maybe bring down the control center. Now you can choose to play a specific podcast, but you can also leave that podcast area blank and it will just resume whatever podcast you were previously playing. So if I run the shortcut, you see it started playing the last podcast I listened to, which was Movies on the Side, my other podcast about movies. So you could choose a specific podcast or leave it blank just to start playing the recently played. But the next shortcut you could do is actually skipping the intros of podcasts that you know kind of have predictable long intros. Primary Technology has no ads at the beginning, just FYI if you want to listen. But in this, I actually have a menu choice. It's going to start one of these podcasts that I know kind of has a predictable introduction. And once it starts playing, it's actually going to fast forward by 2 minutes for the Vergecast. It's going to fast forward 75 seconds for Omnibus. And now I can start playing the latest episode, automatically skip the intro, and I can do all of it right from the lock screen shortcut. All right, now we're going to go into some rapid fire shortcuts. You might have seen these in previous videos, like for the action button and other requests, but you can add a voice note shortcut right to the lock screen. When I run this shortcut, it's going to start dictating the text. It's going to transform that into actual plain text and add it to a note in my Apple Notes. So you can see it's been dictating. Now, if you stop talking for a few moments, it will stop actually dictating it, even though I have it set for on tap, which is a little frustrating. Maybe that'll be fixed. But I'm going to hit always allow, and now it's going to create a new note with the date, the time, and the dictated text right there. Quick way to create a note and jot down ideas right from the lock screen. You can also run translation right from the lock screen. This is especially helpful if you don't have an action button, but you do translate pretty often. I start with another dictate text action. I choose what language I'm translating to, which is English to Spanish, and then it's going to speak that translated text back to me. Let's try that. You should definitely subscribe to my YouTube channel because you're going to learn lots of tips for iPhone, iPad, and Mac, plus, of course, many shortcuts.
Definitivamente deberías suscribirte a mi canal de YouTube porque vas a aprender muchos consejos para iPhone.
And there you go, translate from that shortcut right on the lock screen. Also, if you have an Apple TV, you can add a one-step shortcut here. Just search for TV, and you'll see there's Wake Apple TV. You can even open an app on a certain Apple TV. So let's choose Wake Apple TV. I'll do the one here in the studio. And then you can even open an app on that Apple TV after it wakes up. We can do something like open YouTube. And now when I run the shortcut, it'll wake my Apple TV and open a specific app. You can also go more in-depth if you have multiple Apple TVs. I'll show you one of the shortcuts I use all the time, which is my Watch Something shortcut. And here, I actually have a menu where I choose which Apple TV or what room I'm in. And if I'm in my family room, which has my full theater set up, it wakes the family room TV, sets my HomeKit scene, which dims the lights, and it also starts my Hue sync box, so the lights start syncing to the content, and then it opens the Apple TV remote control for that Apple TV on this iPhone. If you want to learn more about some of my home automations, check out this video above or in the description, and I walk through this setup as well. If you're in and out of the car a lot, this shortcut might be useful, where it actually will do different things depending on whether or not you're in a stationary vehicle using one of the new iOS 17 actions, Get Physical Activity, or if the vehicle is moving. If I run this shortcut and I'm just sitting in my car not driving, it's going to run my home ETA shortcut, which gets my distance to home and travel time, and it texts that to my spouse. Or if the car is already moving, then it's going to skip forward when I'm listening to a podcast 3 minutes to skip the ads. This is a fun shortcut to play around with, especially if you're driving a lot and you want to make sure you get that text home. Speaking of home ETA, that's the next shortcut here. I'll put a copy of this shortcut in the video description without my address, but you put your home address here, get driving directions from current location to home, then you can have that message be home in however many minutes and send that text to whoever you'd like. We covered this in the ChatGPT shortcuts and if you have an action button, but now that you can put it on the lock screen, you can start a voice conversation with ChatGPT right from that lock screen shortcut in iOS 18. That's a one-step shortcut. Just add the Start Voice Conversation with ChatGPT action there. And finally, you can do a shortcut menu, have lots of different options, like maybe turning on the flashlight, running that voice note shortcut we have, or our home ETA, maybe toggle the mute and media volume for your device, and have that shortcut menu run when you tap it on the lock screen. This way you can have multiple powerful options right there on the lock screen every time you run that shortcut. So those are 18 shortcut ideas you can build or download right now, but once iOS 18 launches, you'll be able to put right on your lock screen for quick access. Speaking of which, don't forget to subscribe to the channel because as iOS 18 comes out for the public betas and more updates, I'll be covering them right here on the channel. Hit that like button, by the way, and if you have shortcuts requests, leave them in the comments. I have a ton of requests from a bunch of you already, and I have my next request video coming soon, so be on the lookout for that. You might want to hit the bell icon so you don't miss any future videos. And if you want to see some of the powerful shortcuts you can build with ChatGPT specifically, I'll put that video right up here. And if you are interested in seeing a full tour of my smart home, which is 100% Apple HomeKit, I'll put that video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.